So what I would do is this part first, clubs parallel to the ground, learn how to create speed and hit the ball solid from there first. Stay there till you hit it solid. Then once I can do that, I'd lengthen it out and go to left arm parallel. So here's the club parallel. The next progression would be left arm parallel. So now I'm about this far back. Same things, I'm gonna push down and forward and try and create as much speed and power as I can. Hey guys, Eric here outside at the Bethlehem Golf Club. In today's video, we're gonna talk about a float load progression drill. Now, before we dive into that and how to do it, I wanna talk to you briefly about CogornoGolf.com. Now, we created CogornoGolf.com to remove the barrier between you and I so I can be your personal golf coach wherever you are in the world. As a member of CogornoGolf.com, you're able to send me your swings. I can give you personal feedback, build you a personal practice plan. You get access to all of our videos, all of our master classes, and over 500 exclusive videos that are on CogornoGolf.com, not available anywhere else. Whether you're looking to break 100, fix your putting, fix your slice, just can't get over the hill with your swing, I would love to be the one that helped. We'll put a link to CogornoGolf.com in the description down below. Now, in today's video, we're gonna talk about this float load progression drill. A couple of weeks ago, we did a video called the only drill or one drill to fix your entire swing. And what that was the float load drill. Some of you guys have seen that, some of you haven't. We'll put a card or a link in the description so you guys can watch that video. But a lot of questions came in, hey, how do I transfer this to my full swing? How do I progress here beyond this initial drill that we gave you, that JT and I did? So that's what we're gonna talk about here. Now, first, before we talk about how you progress with this float load drill, let's just kind of go back over what the float load drill is. So the float load drill that we did here, right, from before, what that drill is when you make your backswing, we're gonna get the club head to parallel to the ground. We've got the right arm pretty darn straight. We got the right wrist unhinged. From a full pause spot, we're gonna feel like we're loading the shaft in transition, and from this full paused wide little takeaway, I wanna create as much speed as I can and hit a shot into my full follow through. That's our float load drill. We're quite literally floating the club back, loading it in transition and into the downswing. Now the point of that is to create some of this dynamic motion, get some lag in transition, start to build some power, speed, compression, hit the ball more solid. So what that looks like in real motion, again, we'll do one practice one. Right arm's very wide, it's very unhinged. And then I'm trying to create as much speed as I can from there through the hit. So we'll do one of those here with the ball. So back to here. And then I'm trying to create as much speed from that spot as I can. And what you'll notice, like that one's as long or as farther than my full swing. Now the point of this and why it's float load is the club's quite literally floating back, right? If I was gonna float something back, my right arm would be wide, my wrist would be unhinged. A float back wouldn't look like this, right? That's like a snatch back, right? This is a float back, right arm wide, unhinged. And then as I'm pressing down and forward with my lead hip, lead shoulder pressing, you see naturally that shaft wants to load more in transition. I can use that speed. That's the float load. I'd recommend it virtually to everyone to build good sequencing, hit the ball better, start getting rotation, power, etc. Put that video out, good reaction, and then a lot of people said, hey, okay, cool, how do I transfer this to my regular swing? And there's two answers to that. Number one is time, right? This isn't one of those things you like to try at one time on the range and then just transfer it right away to the golf course with all your swings. You have to train this in. So I would say with this, you know, if you did 20 reps 3 days a week for the next 12 to 24 months, that would be awesome. Now, of course, no one here wants to hear 12 to 24 months, so let's talk about how we speed that up, but certainly time's part of the answer. All right, Eric, I don't wanna take 12 to 24, what do I do? The answer is you lengthen it. So what I would do is this part first, clubs parallel to the ground, learn how to create speed and hit the ball solid from there first. Stay there till you hit it solid. Then once I can do that, I'd lengthen it out and go to left arm parallel. So here's the club parallel. The next progression would be left arm parallel. So now I'm about this far back. Same things, I'm gonna push down and forward and try and create as much speed and power as I can. Now remember when we did the first one, I failed to mention here, but in the last video, when I get to here, the separation I'm trying to build, right, in transition, I'm actually feeling my arms and hands pull up and back as my lower body goes down and forward. That's really what I'm feeling there. Arms and hands up and back, lower body down and forward. So when I go to the next progression, left arm parallel, I'm still feeling my right arm wide, I'm still feeling less hinge, a little bit more because it's longer. Now from here, I'm feeling my arms and hands pull up and back as my lower body works down and forward. And again, that's gonna create a natural sort of whipping motion of the shaft, speed, contact, etc. So what that would look like as the next part would be here, left arm parallel. And then there, I'm trying to do the same thing. Now that one I hit a little bit heavy, and I haven't done this part of the progression much, right? I need to work my way up to this as well. So let's try that one more time. But it's the same sort of sensations, wider right arm, less hinge, pull up and back as my body goes down and forward. And that was better. And that's the next progression. So how do we transfer that to our full swing? Well, we get closer and closer and closer to a full swing length, right? Part of this drill, it doesn't transfer because I'm only this far back. But now when I go left arm parallel, now I'm about a three-quarter swing. So wide right arm, less hinge, pull up and back as I push down and forward. And as I'm doing this, you know, I'm looking to hit the ball solid, certainly, but I also probably want to take a look on video. If I'm someone who has a hard time getting the handle forward, doing any of those moves, I want to make sure I'm doing the motion right first and foremost. So left arm parallel, right, wide right arm, less hinge, pull up and back with the hands as my lower body goes down and forward. And that's building in the same progression. I'd say that'd be step two. Now, once you get that good, what I would do is just go to a pretty full swing length. So instead of me left arm parallel, I'm gonna go all the way up to the top pretty much. What am I gonna feel as I start down? Arms and hands are gonna pull up and back as I work down and forward. So pretty full swing, same sort of sensations. Push my arms and hands up and back as my lower body goes down and forward. So pretty full length motion. And then I'm gonna feel the same piece. And again, I mean, that ball's bombed. I don't have my TrackMan here, but that's probably 20 yards longer than my normal. And the reason is because when I do that pull up and back and push down and forward, that's where the speed is created. So that's the progression drill. You master it here and don't rush. Like, this is not a do this and then go play golf that week and own it, right? You own it, you do it here, months. You do it here, months. And you do it all the way up top, months. And then I'm trying to grab a feel. What did that feel like? All right, well then when I make a real swing, maybe once my hands get above my shoulder, I'm gonna start pushing down and forward, right? My downswing's gonna feel like it starts a little sooner. Hands get up past my shoulder. I'm gonna push down and forward with my lower body. That's how I would start transferring the feels. So when you make a real swing, once you get to here, you're gonna start pushing down and forward as your arms and hands go up and back. So that's the float load progression drill. That's exactly how I do it. Again, spanned over months of time. I think this is good for everyone to learn how to hit it solid. You don't need to do this with driver. You don't need to do it with sand wedge or fairway hybrid. Just do it with one short iron, but then the same feels should work with all the clubs. So float load progression drill, hopefully that helps. If you guys have any questions, as always, leave a comment down below. Hey guys, thanks for watching today's video. If you liked the video, do us a favor, click that like button down below. Click the notification bell. Also, please subscribe if you haven't. If you do like these style of YouTube videos, we're gonna go ahead and put a card on the screen for another video very similar to this one, a little more detail on this topic. If you do want more coaching from myself, help build you a personal game plan to take your game to the next level, go ahead and click the Cogorno Golf logo on the screen. Thank you guys for watching.